health and physical health are two sides of the same coin. Is it possible for you to have physical health without mental health? Is it possible?
You can have physical health and not mental.
Is it possible to have physical health without mental health? Not really, right? Because some physical health, mental crazy can shoot somebody, right? They got locked up. And physical health, we saw knowing what's right and wrong, commit crime, taking use drugs. So you need to have mental health in order to, so likewise, we cannot have mental health without physical health. Because your physical deteriorating, you're becoming depressed. So we need both, okay? But you need to work on both sides, okay? Okay, here's the World Health Organization. What did it say?
Mental health is a state of well-being in which the individual realizes his or her own abilities, can cope with the normal stresses of life, can work productively and fruitfully, and is able to make a contribution to his or her own community.
The same thing that I just said earlier, right? Develop your ability, right? And learn how to cope with life and contribute to your community, right? It's the same thing, right? Yeah. Purpose well-being, social well-being, meaning basically is sports well-being, social well-being. Now we also need financial as well, because no money, you have no money, you starve. So where money come from? Come from work, productive work, right? So that is the total health. Now here's another way to look at health. Two-dimensional model. Health is a state of complete physical mental health, not merely the absence of disease. Mm-hmm. Even if you have no disease, but if you do not have the other part, you are still not healthy. Let me show you how. Now this is a more curved model. So here, horizontally, is the absence, health in terms of absence of symptoms, absence of disease, okay? But that alone doesn't define health. But you also need to have the presence of hope, optimism, joy, your total health, I mean your flourishing. You need to have low or no mental illness, but also high hope, high joy, so that's flourishing. So if just this part, without this part, incomplete mental health. Do you follow me? You need both. Not just the absence of disease, but also the presence of positive mental health. The presence of joy, meaning, hope, faith, everything that makes life tick, okay? Now here another way Frankl and I talk about. Now this way, horizontal way, is the flat land. The flat land of pursue happiness and success, the flat land. But if you live only on at this level, the best you can get is a shallow life. Eat, drink, and be merry. Tomorrow you die. It's shallow life. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's okay, you know what? But you flip around the vertical level, you have meaningful fulfillment. Live a meaningful life. Okay, now, watch. So if you have meaning, if you're able to succeed, the ideal life. Even if you fail, like Van Gogh, hitting soil in a picture, but he still live a meaningful life, right? You can still have a meaningful life even if you do not succeed in the world. So your life is not wasted. And if you do not have a spiritual meaning dimension, then your life is wasted life. You will fail. So if you live at this level, you fail when you succeed, you fail when you fail. But if you live a meaningful life, you cannot fail. When you succeed, you live a new life. When you fail, you still live a meaningful life. Does that make sense? It's a good way to bet on your future, to bargain your future by choosing the meaning path, right? Because you can't lose. Some of that, you can't lose. So we need to change our life orientation from here, live in a flat land, to vertical, and to seeking God, seeking spirituality, seeking meaning. It will change everything for you. I guarantee you, or money back guarantee, if you choose pursue meaning spirituality, your life will be better, okay? Otherwise, I'll give you back your $5. I say same thing to my client, but nobody ever collect money back. Mm-hmm. I say, if you follow my pointer, you get better. Otherwise, money get money back guarantee. I told that to my student too, but nobody ever collect money back. Yeah, so I think I'm doing quite well, okay? Now, Brock Benson wrote a book, The Other Side of Happiness, Embracing a More Fearless Approach to Living. You know, this book, nobody pay attention. It's important. He is saying that we create a generation of young people, tell them to avoid pain, pursue happiness, success. We create a generation of weaklings. They are going to learn how to cope with life demands. They are going to learn how to cope with failure, setback. Don't expect, or optimism means expect success. That's nonsense. Optimism means accept success by overcoming difficulties. Not just expect success. So his book says that because of people's social pressure to pursue happiness, success, and avoid pain, it makes them vulnerable to mental health issues. So when the world around us collapse, or when the pressure closing in upon us, we just fall apart because there's nothing in us that enable us to cope with empty inside. There's no resources. Because all the happiness stuff. The car is a house of car. It's a house built on sand. It's not a house built on solid rock. You do not have the inner resources to cope with the horrors